Nice outfit. Should be required wearing for the zoning board. We could do the colonial zoning board.
Was it good?
Yeah.
Not a judge.
What the hell are you doing here?
I'm in drag today. I'm in drag.
Brady's got them all.
Every day. Careful.
This is next door neighbor. That's why he don't show up sometimes. Hey.
How's the horn sound?
Guaranteed.
Guaranteed to take your socks off.
Are you bad?
I'm not peeing on anything.
Coming through.
Hi, Linda.
Hi, Channel 17. Thanks for doing such a great job.
Thank you.
the right picture. Get the right picture.
Got it, Jimbo.
Thank you.
Have a cookie.
Hi.
Have a cookie. Would you like to decorate it?
Thinner, thinner, thinner.
There's only a few things that could be wrong here because it is really simple.
I'd like to turn the microphone over to Paula Martin, our chairperson, our citizen of the year, and all around really nice person. Paula.
Are you all having a wonderful time today?
Hey!
Well, I am so excited to see so many people. I think that was a wonderful parade, and thank you to everybody who has participated to make this a wonderful success. We are so well blessed and excited to have several dignitaries for the great state of New Hampshire. And I'm going to start out by introducing Governor Lynch, who's currently the governor of the wonderful state of New Hampshire. Let's hear a welcome round of applause.
Thank you all very much. Let me take a moment and introduce my wife, the First Lady, Susan Lynch, is here with me. Well, happy birthday, Sandown. It's really wonderful to be here. Thanks for inviting Susan and me, and my son is around here somewhere, to this great parade. You know, Sandown is such a wonderful, wonderful town. And what you all have something very special, and it really reflects, I think, what is so great about New Hampshire. I have a proclamation I'd like to read. It's a commendation for Sandown 250th anniversary. Whereas Sandown, New Hampshire is celebrating its 250th anniversary in 2006, whereas Sandown, New Hampshire was incorporated on April 6, 1756, when it separated from Kingston, whereas Sandown, New Hampshire was originally a farming community that used its position on the Exeter River to power small family-run mills, and whereas Sandown, New Hampshire is home to many prized historic natural and cultural resources, now therefore I, John H. Lynch, Governor of the State of New Hampshire, do hereby commend Sandown, New Hampshire for its contributions to the rich culture of the state for the past 250 years. I'd like to give this commendation to Paula for the great work that she has done. Congratulations to all of you. Thank you.
Thank you. Before Governor Lynch leaves, we want to give him two of our beautiful pewter commemorative ornaments that are made for our birthday as a token of our appreciation for his time, for he and the First Lady to come and celebrate our wonderful town with us. And now I'd like to introduce Senator Barnes and State Representatives Jean Sharon from Chester and Elizabeth Sanders from Danville, and they have some special salutations for Sandown as well.
Thank you. Actually, she made a mistake. My name is George Washington, and it's not Jack Barnes, but that's okay. Happy birthday, Sandown. None of you look 250 years old. I might, but you guys don't. What we have a couple of items here that we'd like to pass on to you. And the first item that I have, it's a letter, and it's from the United States Senate, August 12, 2006. Dear friends, we are pleased to join in your celebration of the 250th anniversary of Sandown. The Granite State is fortunate to have an excellent quality of life in many historic cities, towns, and villages that give New Hampshire residents reason to be proud of where they live. Sandown is no exception. Sandown's charm is just as evident to the visitors who pass through as it is to those who call it home. Sandown citizens today remain, much like its citizens of 1756, independent, responsible, and hard-working. And we hope that all who attend the festivities understand that each resident has a role to play in carrying the great legacy of Sandown's past into the future. And it's best wishes to all of you. And it's sincerely signed by our U.S. Senator Judd Gregg and our U.S. Senator Johnny Sununu. And we pass this on so you folks can have this. You were all watching the governor and you saw the size of his proclamation. This one's a little bigger. And the reason for that is it represents 424 senators and state representatives, and he's only one. So you can tell by the size who really runs the state. Right, Governor? See, the governor agrees. Here it is. It's a resolution from the state of New Hampshire, the General Court. It's our joint declaration. Let it be known that the General Court of New Hampshire, being comprised of the Senate and the House of Representatives and defined by the state constitution as
having the supreme legislative power on this occasion, does publicly honor and recognize
and does generously grant its heartiest and sincerest congratulations to the town of Sandown, New Hampshire, in recognition of its 250th anniversary of incorporation, and be it known further that the General Court of New Hampshire, by virtue of the signatures inscribed below, does duly proclaim and bestow its highest accolades and plaudits. Signed by the President of the Senate, Theodore Gatzis, Senator Jack Bonds, W. Douglas Stammen Jr., the Speaker of the House, Jean P. Sharon and Elizabeth Sanders. Happy birthday, Sandown. God bless.
Well, I want to thank everyone for taking time to come out, and we have so many more things lined up for you. We're going to have Fife and Drum come out and play some more for us. They're from Arlington. We're so excited they came all the way up. We have a reenactment of a town meeting that'll happen at 2 o'clock at the old meeting house. And of course there's field games and all kinds of other activities. A dedication for the Liberty Tree will be at 3:30, and that will be down at the depot. And then make sure that you take advantage of all that wonderful apple crisp and those beautiful commemorative ornaments so that you can have a piece of this to remember forever. Those are going to make absolutely wonderful gifts for your grandchildren, your children, weddings, bar mitzvahs, Christmas. So make sure that you get some. They are limited edition. And so now I'm going to turn it back over to the Minutemen.
One thing.
Yes, sir.
I have an amendment to what I said earlier. You know, you've got a lot of hard-working people in this town. This lady is one of them, Mrs. Spinelli and her crew. You saw a lot of people that put this parade together and this these festivities together, and that didn't happen by accident, guys and gals. So when you see these folks that were involved with it, be sure to say thank you, because they deserve a tremendous round of applause. They've done a great job for the town of Sandown.
can I,
I hope the donuts are gone by now.
Once again, we're really trying to,
isn't that pretty?
Get the sales going on those. They support
TV that's for sale over there for $5. So if you like the...
Vino Vineyards here in town. It's a new vineyards that's opening now down on Main Street on the right-hand side. This is a beautiful facility that Mr. Zanello has down there. It's available for functions, and they did a wonderful job. You have to see this property to believe it, and this vineyard is just a great addition to the town and to the whole area. 50 on and go, is that $50, 50 bit of 50 now, 50 on and go. Say 50 bit of $40, bit of 40 bit of 30 on and go, is that $30, bit of 30, put it, bit of 30 now, 30 bit of 25, said 20 on and go. We have a t-shirt, we have a hooded sweatshirt, we have a t-shirt, and a bag. Hurry, hurry, on a do, hurry, hurry, on a do. Here, a bit of 50 on a go, is that $50, bit of 50 now, 50 now, $50, bit of 50 now, 50 now, 40 now, 30. Said 30 on a go, is that $30, 20 got 25, bit of 5, 20 got now 5, 25, bit of 5, $20. Now, Kevin Euclid signed, hurry, 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 on a do here. You know, the Mothers Club does a lot for this town all year long, and all their money is coming right back here into town. Here, on the signed autograph, Euclid's first baseman. Here, bid $100 on him and go. $190. That sold to Evan Martin. The dugout is there to your right, just a little bit. The on-deck circle is as close as where Paula and I are now. David Ortiz is that big when you get close to that man. These were the best day that a father and son could have ever. And my son and I are not going to bid on these. We already talked about it, and I said, no, I can't, because you know, I knew that they were going to ask me to do it, and it isn't fair to be a pig and take them 2 years in a row. But I tell you, you are going to have a day. Oh, there's also parking, right? Reserve parking. I didn't have that last year. Okay. What do you want to do here? They're donated by a doctor from Boston that Brigham and Women's. Okay, yeah, I was going to say, one of your ladies' bosses, right? These, yeah, excellent. I got $375, $400 I got, $425, that $400 bid, you're in it. Sold, $425. Worked with the conservation to sell the barn and the land between the barn to up to the meeting house is now going to become town property. He's selling off this house with existing about 3 acres of land, and there'll be one more long driveway and another beautiful home built to suit behind. The house is open. This house was made and built in 1740s. It is a great example of colonial workmanship, and I really appreciate Brian Norman for all of his cooperation and consideration in allowing us to use his land to do this. And he is here. He's a gentleman right there in the blue. And we thank him very much for allowing the town of borrowing his land like this for this.